Yo, B. They ready. Let's go.
I'm feeling myself.
What's up, world?
I'm feeling myself.
Ooh.
Almost some hood girls looking back at it, and a good girl in my tax bracket. Got a black card and less sex habit. These Chanel bags is a bad habit. I do balls.
We back in this thing. We missed you last week.
And I'm feeling myself, Jack Rabbit. Feeling myself, back off. Cause I'm feeling myself, Jack Gore. Can he think about me when he wax off? Wax on? That national anthem hat sauce.
Hey.
And I heard that nigga like a bad
What's
horse.
Up, everybody? Happy Friday.
I'm feeling myself.
I hope you out there feeling yourself this Friday night. Cause if you don't do it, who else will?
Digital pop, I
stop
the world.
What up, DJ
Swift?
Now I'm female,
it
make no difference.
Hey.
I stop the world.
Okay.
Pretty on fleek. Hey. Pretty on fleek. Pretty gang always keep them niggas on geek. Biting through Texas. Feed them for his breakfast. Every time I whip it, I be talking so much.
We always gotta get this party started.
Yeah, nigga, you right.
I think I see my favorite person.
I say, yes, daddy, I do. Give me brain like NYU.
Let's go.
Teach me, nigga, teach me. All this learning here is by you.
I'm whipping that work. Keep digging that work. I got it. Got the sense of that real. Bounce, baby. Don't get you some that bounce, baby.
Oh, now you did it. Did you start it out with the Queen Bee? Woo! On fire, I say. You are on fire.
Girl, listen, you know I had to do what I had to do to get in motion tonight. And music, you know, it shifts that mood. So I had
Yes, it definitely does. Girl, we took a break last week.
We took a break because breaks are necessary.
Breaks are definitely necessary. And you know what? It's so crazy. I'm going to just see if I can turn this up. It's so crazy because we started this thing on a little humbug. It wasn't even for real. And then it just turned into something that we love to do.
Yes. And then
that is amazing.
Stuff to do. So it was like, well, this is our little baby.
What happened?
I need to charge up my phone. I need to charge my phone. So I'm going to grab a charger. So you got to keep the people entertained while I go do that.
This is why we got these slides, y'all. So you know what, tonight, normally it's me with technical difficulties. And because it ain't me with technical difficulties, I'm just going to send up a little sip for that. Thank goodness. Because normally I'm on here like, I can't go live. My phone won't turn around. What's up, DJ Sincere? What's going on out there? When are you going to start throwing some DJ Nights? Is that, what is it? DJ Nights? Is that it? When you going to start throwing some of those parties out here on Instagram so that the people will be like, DJ Sincere rock the party, because we know you keeps it right and you keeps it tight. Destiny Dawn Amor is on the line. We're gonna have to bring her in tonight because is she celebrating her birthday? She's at the Intercontinental.
Ooh.
And we're just gonna have to say shout out to her real
shout
quick
out. Happy birthday. We love it. Okay, I'm ready to get into this thing.
Let's do it.
I hope that our guest called in. I hope he knows to call in. That's all.
Oh, okay. Well, I do know that before we get on into that thing, you know, we are always about, you know, igniting and supporting our people.
Yes.
So just this week, guess what I got? Dun, dun, dun.
What is it?
I got my pen from the rhinestone stair. And he sent me this.
I haven't got mine yet, but that's because my mail situation is crazy, and then I'm crazy going to get it. So tell me about what was in the package when you got it.
Okay, so let me say this, guys. It's a beautiful pen. Just beautiful. I'm wearing it tonight, and it stands for supporting the LGBTQ community and all that good stuff. And also, he sent me a handwritten card.
Come on,
and it's got a little health message on there. Remember to choose. Oh, maybe I thought this was a health message, but when I read it again, I feel like it's joy. I thought he said, remember to choose soy. But it's joy. So it had a little handwritten message. I thought it was soy. Rhinestone stairs seemed like pink.
That is hilarious.
He's drinking his water. Eating his pineapple.
You got him up on your screen back there, on the official screen.
Yes, on the official Kiki Kamado screen. And then, girl, just think. Last week, I'm going to tell you. Last week, I was at one of these major events here in KCK. We don't have a lot, but it was booming down off of one of our more landmarked streets, Quindaro. And I saw the owner and operator of Breathe Beverages.
What?
Go figure, right? And she sent me home with a delicious drink. Mm. And
so
you see?
So that's how her beverages come? That's so cute.
Yes, so she does, you know, like she'll come to your party and she'll, you know, be the bartender and make, you know, a special signature drink. But what's in this is one of her crafted cocktails.
What's it called?
She didn't tell me. But it's just a crafted cocktail. That's what it says. Crafted cocktail to go.
Is that her logo on there?
That's her logo. She's official.
Really nice. You know, I'm so glad you showed that because we talk about things, but you don't know how well someone has packaged their products, how much love and work has been put into that. That's,
girl,
that's beautiful.
This is real. This is under all this nice frostiness from the freezer.
Yeah.
That is her logo.
Oh, I love it. Good.
And it says, the life for your party. The life for your party. And, you know, later on, we'll have somebody in here talking about branding and marketing for your business. Because in the corona, you got a little bit of time to think about being an entrepreneur, right?
And it seems like more and more we are seeing everybody kind of step and move into this lane of self-ownership. Because there's nobody to depend on but you right now, right? It's like, I got to depend on me. So that means that we've all kind of bossed up. But what I love is the share that happens. You know, when you share what you know with me and I share what I know with you, then we have everything we need to really rise to the occasion. So that's exciting.
To push it forward. It's all about pushing forward. It's all about everybody holding their hands, not crabs in a barrel trying to pull each other down. No, we're going to pull each other up. Whenever I got to, you know, do something, we're going to be enterprising and leaning on each other so that we can be resourceful. So that's that. And then I know that you got a couple of things going on.
Like I said, me and my mail are slow. So I do have some other Black-owned products in my mailbox probably, but I haven't gotten my mail. So what I do have that I bought a couple weeks ago, I bought waist beads from a Black-owned company. She made them all with colors that I wanted. Do you have her little flyer? I think it's Shaquila Simone.
Yes.
Was out
the
there.
Official screen has
what is it called? What's the name of her business?
It's called I'm not gonna say her first name. Shaquila Stones is the name of the company. Shaquila Stones.
Okay, Shaquila Stones. And I wanted to support Shaquila because Shaquila is she is not only making this jewelry, but she's also a DJ. She goes by the name of DJ Dollface. Shout out to her. And so just in the spirit of everything you said, she was stepping out into some of her entrepreneurial desires. And she created these beads, these waist beads. And she's got a lot because you can get your stones. You can get, you know, whatever kind of chakra energy that you want to bring into your life. But I just wanted to do something decorative. And I wanted to be conscious of not letting my stomach just go all the way to the
This keeps not, you in remembrance not, of this
work. It might be too late for me and the stones. So the chakra stones. But wait. I feel like I have a visitor who might know something about that. You hear a doorbell? Come on in. Oh, who are you, young lady?
Come on in here.
Hey.
Okay,
she just clowning.
Right, I have to come up in here, right? Okay.
Yes. I'm gonna need me one of. Can I get one of these masks, please?
You can get one of these.
We can't talk about the corona if we don't have coronavirus. It's getting real.
So we've got a special guest in. We love to call that an in studio guest. This is our other friend, Adrienne McClain. There she goes. She's also her original kimono from
Disney. Original kimono. Okay, look at this. Look at the arms. Like, this is original, guys.
She's part of our family. Our family of kimonos. So we are so glad to have her in Kansas City hanging out with us tonight. Have fun!
How much fun is this?
Oh, yes, I come to slay, baby. Girl,
you
slay, honey. The dollar store, okay?
Anything, but
we keep it real. It's the coronavirus.
No,
honey.
I mean, you can buy so many good things at the dollar store. Okay,
just if you want one, I won't feel nobody.
So wait. I'm sorry, I changed it. So let's talk about these Maddie masks while we're at it, because I changed it. Yeah, where's my mask?
We will have to get you masks. So, throughout this coronavirus, y'all, like they said before, we have been inspired to, like, start businesses and thinking of different ways and different plans. I have a fabulous 5-year-old, okay?
Fabulous.
She is fabulous. She is creative. Masks by Maddie. This is all her creation, okay? So, she designs the mask herself at 5 years old. So, I brought some of the masks. So, they're tie-dye. I don't know if you can
take them out. Take the one I'm going to buy out the packaging.
Yes.
Not the one that other people, because they have been sterilized.
Look how cute they are. So they are washed. This is like the unicorn rainbow one. Ooh, and like the tie-dye. Isn't that cute?
Auntie, so you want that for her.
So I think it's so cool for adults to be able to buy some fun kid-friendly masks for their kids. And to know that they were made, yes, yeah, hard to see in the package, but to know that they were made with love by a 5-year-old is amazing.
This is the one I'm going to buy that's out of the package. And just let me just, some appliques on there.
We love
it's
it.
So pretty. Thank you, Maddie. Auntie loves you.
Yes.
This was mine. I'll cash out you soon.
Just joined us. Rhinestone Stair. What's up, friend? We just did a segment on you. We showed your pin.
She's rocking your pin. She's rocking the pin.
And we
forget these laid edges. I'm gonna let it drip on us.
Yes. So we celebrate. We just clowning tonight. But what we have are Mask by Maddie. Which is a
fun. Where my package? I need my package. Where my package?
Here's your package.
Thank you. Okay, so let's get on with the get up. So we've got all that going on, and just so appreciative and happy that Adrienne is here to join us. And she did something in the COVID that we're talking about tonight, is rising to the occasion, as you said earlier. Like, sometimes in the COVID, you got to figure out a way to deal and to cope and to be resilient and to keep your sanity. most importantly, keep your sanity. So that's why Adrian Renee is here. And I always like to say, I don't know why I like to say Adrian Renee. I say it a lot, don't I?
You do.
That's why Adrian Renee is here tonight, because she's keeping her sanity, okay? So we got that going. Barely. What we're going to start out with real quick is the Angieism of the night.
Oh, okay. We're starting out with the Angieism of the night. This one came to me, y'all. My friend just said, like, Angie, do some t-shirts. You say crazy stuff all the time. I said, listen, it just comes to me. I don't know why. But we were talking this week, and it's so much happening. And we're going to get into all the things that 2020 has brought. But when we were talking, I think we were discussing Jada and the August situation. And I think I said, come on, the fans came out. I said, my Angieism of the week is 2020 can handle it. Okay? That means that this is the year that if you have something on your mind or your heart, I believe 2020 can handle it. It's like, ooh, what's going to happen? No telling, but 2020 can handle it. Will and Jada, they going to be all right. Come on.
Because 2020 can handle it.
2020 can handle it. I want you all to be bold in your approach when you're having these tough conversations that sometimes need to be had. When we're seeing all kind of things happen, it's just a remembering that 2020 can handle it. I said 2020 can handle monster. Jada Pinkett's truth.
Yes. That's a new mantra. You know, when we were kicking it on the eve of 2020, my caption was, 2020, we ready. But now we're in this thing, 2020, we were ready, and 2020 can handle it. That means that we can handle it. Mm-hmm. This thing ain't got us. Mm-hmm. Corona ain't got us. Hashtag.
You know, there's something about knowing that 2020 can handle it that, to me, frees me up. It says, hey, I can go ahead and just be honest about what that is. I can go ahead and just keep it real about that, because 2020 got
2020 can handle it.
I mean, because what else? What could I really say that would be worse than Corona? Like, what could I say that would be worse than Corona?
Okay, worse than staying at home and being a teacher. Okay. For 3 months, and now we're gonna have to be a teacher for 3 more months.
But then on
2020 can handle it.
But then on the flip side, there's that echo of resilience that just resonates over and over and over again inside of us, and that is the word of the day: resilience, the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties. Toughness. And a lot of times people say, do you have mental toughness? And that was like a phrase, you know, it's like a it's like a catchphrase, but it's a real quality. Do you have the mental toughness? Do you have the stuff that it takes? While 2020 is handling it, do you got the stuff that it takes to bounce back and the capability to recover? Because we do. I love the word resilience.
I think people are finding that out more and more every day. Like, what you didn't think was possible is possible. Like Adrian just said, she didn't know that she would be at home taking care, all of a sudden becoming a teacher for a four-year-old and working. But she did it. You are here to tell the story because you handled it.
Hallelujah.
And you didn't know. You would have thought from a distance, like, I can't do that.
Yeah.
But this thing keeps showing us what we're made of, right?
What we're made of. And also it shows us our village as well. Because the village, it helped. You know, it tells you who your friends are, who your real friends are through all of this as well. So the resilience in who you are, and then it shows you what matters most. Like friends and family at this point is it. You know, came through in the fourth quarter.
In the fourth. Well, we weren't even in the fourth. I don't know about sports. I feel like February and March was like the first quarter. I feel like it was the first, but I do know about finances, so it was the first quarter. We were in the first quarter, the family came through. But the thing is that I always like to say, and we like to say, find your tribe and love them hard. Because if you don't, then you out here, you just a ship without a sail. You know, you just out there going.
Thanks.
So a couple of things, if you guys are out there tonight, we want to know, What has helped you? What are your abilities, your capabilities, your skills, your, you know, your the wherewithal that you show that has helped you get through this COVID quarantine situation? Has it been your organization skills? What has it been? Because some of the things that they say help people get across bad times or tough times is that internal focus of or control. So do you have that, or you have look at those past success and or past things that you did in the past and apply some lesson learned? You know, since I've been home and I've been just here at the house, I've been really focusing on organizing and making the house work really well. So that's something that I've been spending a lot of time on. So while throughout tonight, we want to hear what you all have been doing to get you to the next level.
Yeah, but we definitely, that is our topic this week, Corona, blessings and burdens. We say, you know, we always joke amongst each other, what did the Corona give you? You know, what Corona gave us. And I think amongst our tribe, we have kept our energy high. And Corona was blessing us in ways that we didn't expect, okay? Yeah. There was an adjustment period, okay? But we kept pushing, and before we knew it, I think we had found our legs in this thing, right?
Mm-hmm. And now, I don't want to keep talking about it because there's so many things. Corona definitely has been a devastating force, but there's been many silver linings. Mm-hmm. And we're going to talk about those tonight. And I don't know, first couple of things that we could talk about, and then we'll get to the first person, which is LaToya Rosoff.
Okay.
Or 79 Rose, and I believe she's in the building. Do you see her? One of the biggest things that Corona has given us is Versus.
Yes. Versus was a dope thing that Corona gave us. Some of these things are going to remain, right? Versus, mm-hmm. I want to still see Versus even when we get back out walking around. That was that's a great thing that we got.
That was a great thing. So what was your favorite Versus? What would you say?
Okay, I got mine. A Beanie Man. When we were in Jamaica, listen, I wasn't even going to watch that. Okay?
Me either. I'm so glad I didn't miss out on that. That was such an epic experience.
It was epic. I turned it on and I said, this is what we want. It was live. The energy was there. It was fun. It felt what I loved about those Verses, though, and that's what really kind of got me started. When I would come at home and I would put it on the Bluetooth speaker, and then we would be in our own chat. That first one we watched, I don't know.
Yeah, which one? Was that my husband's birthday? Was it Nelly?
Said, quarantine allowed me to appreciate reset and realize the essence of time. We always feel like we've never had enough time, but truly the most priceless commodity has allowed me to prioritize it. Come on, sis.
I always say that
time is money. And people kind of forgot that in this moment, mm-hmm. that mm-hmm. there was a lot to gain, a lot of value for us here because, you know, I know I've been able to create projects. I have no idea how many weekends and evenings it would have took to try to build that I had mm-hmm. the space and the opportunity to pour my best into. So it absolutely was a blessing. Yeah.
Time is a major gift that Corona has blessed us with. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I could keep going on and on because we always talk about the blessings of Corona, but time is the one. So we'll see if is Toya here. Do we want to get to Toya?
Will you do me a favor? And when I'm talking to Toya, will you see if you can find our other guest? I'm not sure he knew.
I sure will.
Okay.
Okay,
so we'll bring her in, and then we'll bring back, then you come back.
Yeah, okay, bye.
Woo, okay, y'all. Y'all know how this goes. We're about to bring in a guest, and our topic tonight is Corona, blessings, and burdens. But we definitely want to talk to you and hear how this season has affected your life and what you have to bring to this energy. So I'm going to go ahead and bring in our first guest. I love good guests. Y'all know I like to go in with the conversation. Let me put my guest glasses.
Hey. Ah,
what's up?
Hey. How I got my, you can't say that my kimono on. I got my faux kimono on.
Faux.
I got my faux. It's a faux kimono.
Yes. We love it. You got to step back so we can see a little bit of your, of your role.
Let me see.
Because we love it. Yes, friend. Listen, yes, yes. That's what it's about at the Kiki. You got to play along.
Yes.
Welcome. We're so glad to have you here. We want to introduce you. This is, we'll let you introduce yourself and what you represent, because you're representing two dope brands tonight.
Yes, so I'm excited. For those who don't know me, my name is LaToya Rozoff, and I am the operator of a little premier little black dress shop called 79 Rose, which is just a play off the year I was born and my last name.
We love it.
Yes, so we are doing a women's empowerment masterclass tomorrow, which I'm so excited. We are kicking it off, and we thought we respected, like, oh, we'll get 15, maybe 20 women. We have almost 40 women. We're going to be participating tomorrow.
Wow! And get it empowered. 40 women that showed up. Yo, I wish I had some sound effects. I would give you claps right now. You know, that is so beautiful, the support that you're getting. And it's all women. Is that what you said? It's all women, yes. That is so great. Okay, so hold on. You went in on fast on us. So there's a shop. And you sell only little black dresses?
Yes. So I got the idea from my husband's from LA. And so we go every year. And so one year, we always go down to the fashion district where I got my faux kimono. When our trips down to the fashion district, and one time I went down the wrong block. I went down the wholesale block. Mm-hmm. And this girl was trying to sell me some clothes. And of course, I didn't have a license. And she ended up schooling me and telling me the process of getting a license and things like that. And just a little bit of background, I have an undergraduate degree in fashion, merchandising, and business. And so I had always kind of wanted to do something, get back into the fashion field. And so I said, I'm going to open up a little a boutique, you know, clothes. And so kind of going through the process and figuring out what I wanted to do, I landed on a dress shop as a niche. And then a black dress shop was even more niche, because it was like every girl needs a little black dress, right?
Yes.
It's like a closet staple, right?
I love it.
So I niched on little black dresses. And then just hearing feedback from curvy girls, like, you know, you can go, they go to the store, they trying to find dresses to fit them. And, you know, if you have some curves, they have very limited options and the options are not fashion forward. And I was like, aha, that is going to be my niche. I want, you know, the whole mission is to promote body positivity.
Wow.
And self-esteem, right? Because we are women, we so hard on our bodies. And all this happened in the middle of me being pregnant, too.
Yeah.
And so I just think of what my body was going through, being pregnant. And people just say all kind of crazy stuff. How much weight have you gained? Are you worried about snapping back? And I just was like, I wanted something that just empowers women to embrace yourself how God made you. So that is the concept of 79 Rose Black Dress Shop.
That is awesome. So, wow, there is a little black dress shop that is embracing the curves and the just women in all shapes and sizes. We're celebrating that. I think that's so dope, especially to know that there's a place where if I need something cute for the night, I can just stop by and come and see it. Now tell us where your shop is located and how that works, because isn't it by appointment only, or how does your shop work?
Yeah, so I'm located in Kansas City. For those in Kansas City, in Olathe, Kansas, and it is by appointment. And that was designed, obviously, to help me with my work-life balance, right? I got a family, too. And it just also the other part is to have a personal shopping experience, you know, especially like women. Like when you're going somewhere, a special event, you're stressed out. And so I wanted to provide an environment where women just had to worry about trying on dresses. And the biggest problem they would have is just choosing the right one, right?
Wow.
And being like a queen, right?
Wow. Somebody said I felt like a queen. I think that's somebody who came to your shop. So your mission is going out, like what you set out to do. And I've been watching you, you know, I watch you online, but I love just hearing it really clear that like this is celebrating women of all shapes and sizes. So I love that. Yeah. And can you tell us where your shop is?
Yes, it's in Olathe, Kansas, and it is by appointment. So all you have to do is DM me or shoot me an email, and then we'll work out.
Where would they do that? What's your information if anybody out there wants a little black dress? And also tell us, do you deliver if you don't live in it?
Yes, 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 yes. So if you don't, I have a website. So it's 79rose.com. And so okay. I ship nationwide, ship everywhere. And then if you want to reach out to me, 79rose@gmail.com and set up an appointment. And we'll just kind of talk and find the time that works for both of us for you to come in.
All right. Well, listen, you know, the timekeeper said we got 3 minutes. So I need to find out about the event that you're doing tomorrow.
Yes. Yeah. So this is chapter 2. So this started back in March. And so many people came to me. It's like, I want to know about getting in business. I have all these questions about this and about that, about marketing. And so my idea was to create like an empowerment brunch and bring all the subject matter experts in the room and just share. Like, we have this idea that black women don't share, black women can't get along. And I wanted to spell that myth, one, and two, and just empower women. Like, you know, when you have an idea and you just get stuck on that idea because you don't know where to go. And so I wanted to empower other entrepreneurs. Say like, hey, if this is the next step, you need to go, you need to get your license, you need to figure out marketing, you need to figure out this. Yes. And so we had chapter 1 back in March, and it was fantastic. Once again, I think we expected maybe like 10, 15 women. We had 35 women come out.
Wow.
And then people just shared and empowered each other, and it was just really good feedback. And then so this class tomorrow is going to focus on branding your business and getting your business funded, which are two things that are the biggest headache for anybody trying to start out with any idea.
How you to said branding your business and getting funding for your
funding
business.
Your business. Wow. And then budgeting too. And so we have 4 different sessions. And so we're going to have 4 different speakers. We're going to kick off with Brandon. I have like one of the best branding people, actually nationwide. She's known for her services. She's coming and she's going to talk about just the fundamentals of branding. And then we're going to kick it out to another girl who's going to talk about social media and like knowing how to post and when to post and knowing the insights and all that fun stuff. Then we're going to kick it off to a local educator. She's dynamic and she's going to talk about funding, and she has a whole list of resources when she's done how to get money for your business.
Okay.
And then Craig's gonna end it with budgeting, so she's gonna show you how to budget and keep it in line. So I'm excited. We want everybody
to come back, and we're gonna talk longer, but we also want to know how the event goes. I know that we will be there. Kiki and Kimonas will be in the house in the morning learning how to brand and just building with those 40 women that you got. You know, I'm one of the 40, so I'm so excited to be a part of that community and figuring out how we can all learn how to support each other. So you're doing excellent work, Toya.
Thank you. Thank
Between
you.
Your shop and your confidence building that you're putting out there, and you are empowering women to do, just like we said in this corona, to become entrepreneurs and kind of work their own business. So before I get fired, could you just go ahead and tell us, what has the corona blessed you with?
Oh, yeah. You know what? Corona had to make me step out of my comfort zone. And I had to rethink everything because all my plans were cut in half. And God had to sit me down and said, what you gonna do with what you have? And I said, I don't know. Mm. And he just sat me down for a few weeks until I figured it out. And I had to, and I did. And I just had to, it was all about being nimble. I had to learn to be nimble, right?
Yes. Ooh.
I had to learn to be nimble.
I like to say malleable, you know, but it's the same thing, right? It's learning how to go with the ebb and flow of it all. And that's beautiful. Yes.
Be nimble.
Yeah.
So, like, one of the I know we got to go. One of the speakers said this. It was so powerful. She said COVID level set everybody. So, no matter if you were a celebrity, no matter if you, whenever your socioeconomic status, you still at home trying to figure it out.
Yes.
So what you gonna do?
Yes, yes. The COVID is a truth teller, isn't it? 2020 can handle it, girl.
Right.
Exactly. Exactly. Because it doesn't hide the truth. So thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for sharing with us. And thank you for everything that you're putting into this world. So I'll see you in the morning.
All right. Thank you so much. You guys have a good night.
Thank you.
Bye.
Wow. That's what we wanted tonight, was to highlight those of us that are finding the blessings in this corona. You know, we do need positive vibes, because the easiest thing to do would be to focus on everything that went wrong. Because trust me, stuff went wrong for everybody. Like she said, it's a great leveler. But here we are finding the joy and the light. So I'm going to go ahead and bring in our second guest so that I can get back to the Kiki. And we're adding a little testosterone to the evening. We got a gentleman coming to join the Kiki. I love it when the fellas stop by. Because, you know, people say, this is for everybody. We all love the Kiki. Let me see if he's coming on in. You out there? I think he got, you got to try it again. You know, it's just basic modern science. I said modern science, modern technology. Come on back in here. Come on, I see you. All right, we're going to try it again. Waiting for him. Okay, so, you got to turn off. What's up?
Hey, how you doing, sister?
Look at you, it's good to see you.
Likewise.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are welcome to the Kiki. This is the comedian extraordinaire, Mr. Reggie.
What yes, ma'am.
Reggie Comedy, what you go by?
Yeah, Reggie Jr. Yes, ma'am.
Reggie Jr. What's up?
Nothing much. I'm just out here grinding like glass on gravel.
Come on. Tell us about your grind. Tell us about, I'm watching you from a distance. I see you making moves. So tell us about it and how COVID has kind of influenced the moves you're making right now.
Certainly. So obviously, you know, I've been living in Los Angeles for about 11 years now.
Yeah.
I've been out there doing stand-up, acting, and doing improv as well. I've also been written on a couple of projects out in Los Angeles. So then, you know, when the COVID hit, initially we thought, you know, it'll be like a couple of weeks. And it turned out to be a couple of months. So I came back to Kansas City. So I was like, I'm not going to sit in L.A. for 2 or 3 months, you know, just twiddling my thumbs. I might as well go back home if I'm going to be sitting somewhere. And while I was here, obviously not a lot of comedy going on. I was doing videos online, and I started noticing that a lot of single women were needing, like, certain stuff done, like grass cut and stuff moved and stuff like that. And so I was like, and all I was doing was at home lifting weights and doing sit-ups all day. And I was like, I might as well use this strength.
You know what
I'm saying? So what I started doing.
And then what happened?
Right. So what I started doing was I would say, hey, I'll come cut your grass, and you just donate whatever you got. I didn't even put no price on it. I was just like, you know, just give me whatever you can. Because at that time, people were still scared of the coronavirus. So, you know, funds were short, and I understood that. And at the end of my first day of, like, cutting grass, I had, like, $110 in my pocket. So I was like, oh, this is pretty cool. And then I went out the second day, and I had, like, $150. And I was like, man, I got $200 in my pocket, over $200. And all I did was just cut grass. And so I was like, I think I can make this, you know, an actual thing. And so from that point to this point, I just started investing into my lawn care business, and still I got stuff going on in LA. So I'm still doing auditions in the morning, and I'm cutting grass in the evening, you know, because you do stuff. So
it's making me so happy. I'm so glad I reached out to you, because I love the background behind it. Like, you started out knowing that there are single women out there that needed some help.
Yeah.
And thank God for you, because sometimes people forget to offer that, right?
Right.
And we
right.
see a lot of single women trying to balance it all. So
right.
That's amazing that you set up a service like this. Secondly, how can people find you? So let's say that I know some people that want their grass cut. How do they find you?
Well, the name of the company is on the hat is Hoeing, Blowing, and Mowing.
Wait, what's it say? Say it one more
hoeing, time. Hoeing, Blowing, and Mowing.
You are a clam. Hoeing, Blowing.
Yep. And right mowing. There. Hoeing, yes. Blowing, Mowing.
Thank you. You a clam. That's hilarious.
Yeah. So,
is there a Facebook page?
Yeah, yeah, that's the Facebook. That's the Facebook page.
So I type in hoeing, blowing, and mowing.
Yeah, HBM. Okay. Yeah, just remember HBM. And our motto is let us get off in your grass. You know what I'm saying? And that's
See, this is what happens when a comedian comes to cut your grass. This
right.
This is resourceful and it's so exciting because You took a moment that could have turned anyway,
yeah. And
you've made it into lemonade, friend. Yes, it's funny. It definitely got my attention because it also was just showing your work ethic.
And, yes, ma'am.
You know, that you weren't afraid to get out there and do something that, you know, you weren't just looking for the glamour. You were being honest and forthright in, you know, in everything that you were doing. And that was inspiring.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yeah. And I appreciate the love, man. Like I said, it was, if Corona had not happened, I would have never known you could make this much money cutting grass. Like I've made some really good more money cutting grass this year than I've made in some of my acting gigs. You know, just because.
Yes, friend, I do know.
Yeah, Kansas City grass grows, and so people pay to get it cut, and so.
Because Cray will come back in here. She's serious about that grass, okay?
Yes,
she wants that lawn looking nice every week. And I hope that you got to. Because hoeing, blowing, and mowing is definitely a Kiki and Kimono favorite. He's out there looking out for single women. But he will also cut a gentleman's grass, too.
Yeah, and actually, also too, it wasn't just single women; it was like elderly people or disabled, like anybody that just physically couldn't get out to do it. I was like, "Yo, I'm here doing pull-ups all day. Like, I can do something. I can help people that can't, you know, help themselves." And so, like, it ain't just like it wasn't like I was just like only single women; just like anybody that just can't do the work. I can physically do the work, you know, and I can do, you know, an hour of comedy on stage after, like it. It's nothing, you know what I'm saying?
I love it. You. I was sitting there looking at you, and I was like, wow, I'm just so always in awe of how many amazing people I know and the kind of people that, honestly, that do come out of where we're from, you know?
Right.
Just, you know, you spoke of not only work ethic, but you also care about the people and the community there. And
yes,
that's,
ma'am.
Like, beautiful. Now, tell us some more, because I know my timekeeper is coming. You got to tell me some more about your comedy and where that's heading and how we can find you and support you on your initial endeavor.
Yeah, so Reggie Comedy, if you follow me on Facebook, it's Reggie Comedy. If you follow me on Instagram, it's Reggie Comedy. If you follow me on Twitter, it's Reggie Comedy. If you follow me to my car, it's still Reggie Comedy, you know what I'm saying? So you can hit me up on all platforms, Reggie Comedy, man, especially on IG and on Facebook. I got tons of content. I got a couple writing projects that are coming out this year, like the COVID didn't stop that. So yeah, man, I'm just still you know, grinding and pushing away, and you know, with this with comedy and with my lawn care service, it's like I realized, like, yo, like I don't have to just be an actor or just be a comedian. Like I can actually like diversify, man, and I think sometimes we allow our passions to limit us, you know, like, well, I just sing or I just dance. Nah, like you were put here, you can do so much more than what you put yourself in that box, you dig? So I'm finding out like to explore the capabilities of my brain. You know?
That's it, Reg. That's it, you know, and I was right there with you. And it was so great to again have this time to explore some of the other things that I wanted to do, you know, and you know how it is. Me
right.
And Reggie, not only did we grow up in KC, but we both HBCU, you know what
yep.
I mean? We went to AUC, Atlanta University Center. We got Clark, Atlanta yep. down there, Spelman. And we both have these artist dreams. And mm-hmm. it is so easy to get focused on that and forget, you know, about some of the other skills that we have and the other ways we can use it. So COVID definitely opened up a window for us to not have to worry about that and like say, well, what would I do if I wasn't doing that? Who would I be? And how exciting is right. That to get to live in that expression, because we might not have ever stopped that hustle. We've been hustling for it, and we might have just kept on going. So I'm so grateful and excited for you. Okay, she said we got 2 minutes. Is there anything else you want to share with the people? Is there something we need to know? And why don't, are you going to do some stand-up there in KC? Are you going back to L.A.?
Yeah. Yeah, so I'll be featuring at the Kansas City Comedy Club later on this month in August. So I'll be doing a weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, which is about 5 shows. And I'll have plenty of the merchandise, the HBM, Hoeing, Blowing, and Mowing merchandise. And people can actually purchase this right now, too. This is a real company.
Okay, because listen, I found that people on Kiki and Kimono support. So you're saying your hats are for sale?
Yes, ma'am.
The t-shirt, and is that all when we go to your page, Hoeing?
Yep. Or you can call me at they can call me on my phone number too, 404-357-7243. Or you can hit me up on Facebook, and that's Reggie, and my last name is FLENORY. You can hit me up there, or just hit Reggie Comedy on Instagram.
Reggie Comedy is quick, and you can remember that. So if you want to get on this movement, because you know that hat is funny, and you know, you see that his grind is relentless, and you see that you can support somebody who's not afraid to get out there and support himself.
Right.
So we will go. We'll find you at Reggie Comedy. You can hit him up and say, let me get one of them hats. Or hit him up and say, I got some grass that needs to be cut. Or look, maybe you can pay to get your grandma's grass cut just for a gift. That would be so nice to think of people in ways that we can keep supporting people's business. It doesn't have to directly impact you. You know, you can do it for others. I think we found out what the COVID gave you, Reggie. But if you want to reiterate it, what did the COVID give you?
The COVID, man, just opened up my eyes to maximizing my potential. It's like having a... like having a Ferrari and you only go in first gear. You know what I'm saying? I think we as, especially we as Black people, we have so many more inalienable gifts that we have to stop, you know, just specializing and say, well, I just do taxes. Or like, no, we can do so much more. And I realized that I'm pretty handy with an axe. Like I cut down trees. You know what I'm saying? I've been hauling rock. I've been doing it all. And I still do, you know, I'm still doing my passion. So COVID gave me an experience to be an entrepreneur, and I'm not letting that go. I'm still, even though I'm doing comedy, I'm gonna still keep my lawn care business up and running, because you just never know what'll happen.
I love it. You've done nothing but sprinkle us with hope, nothing but sprinkle us with light. You know, I know I'm inspired, and I'm excited to be right on that journey with you, exploring, you know, all my other gifts while still auditioning by day. You know, we ain't going nowhere. But Kobe said, pump the brakes. And what else you got in there? What else you got in the bag?
Right.
So, I love it. I'm so happy you stopped by. You made my night. You look great.
Thank
I'm
you.
So glad that you in there. You know, keeping them abs, right? I heard
Yeah.
You see, I had to get my waist beads because.
Yeah. Hey, you doing it too.
Yeah, I got to keep myself in remembrance.
Yeah.
Sit over here and Kobe your situation away. We ain't going to do that. Okay, I know I got to go. Mwah.
Yes, it's
so good to see you, and I'm wishing you everything, the best of everything.
Likewise. Right. Yes, sir. Have a good one.
See you soon. Awesome! That was so awesome. Come on back in here, Charlotte. Charlotte keeps us on time, doesn't she? You got to have an official timekeeper, okay? Because y'all know I get into it. I be ready to pull my glasses out and find out all the tea. But she'd be like, pump your brakes, sis. We got a show to do. Because we got to talk more about what COVID did for us. Because what I'm sure of is that COVID definitely has blessed me in ways that I never, ever was even thinking about. Okay? So this is exciting. I'm waiting on you to come on back in here with me, Kiki. And Kimono. But beside that, so you guys, we got, he's so crazy. What he said, his thing was hoeing, blowing, and mowing. Let us get in your grass. Let us cut your grass. I can't remember the hook. But, so you can find it. Remember, that's easy. Reggie Comedy. Go find Reggie Comedy, and he will totally come out, cut your grass, and get you right. And you can get the dope hat and the t-shirt and just support. You know, I'm just waiting on Charlotte, but what I do think is important as we're looking at these entrepreneurs, I know you see all your friends out here starting businesses, starting organizations. I think it's important for us to figure out how we can support them, okay? Because we've supported so many other businesses and organizations for so long. So how do we prioritize that and say, you know what? Instead of buying that little extra thing that I always buy over there, I'm gonna take that money and go spend that with Reggie. You know, we have to shift the narrative so that we can get in. Okay, I'm gonna go on in with, let's see. Are we back, friend? Are we back? But yes, we have to. This has to become important to us every day, how we can support each other. There she goes.
Girl, we were over here. We were loving it. That Reggie.
Hoeing, mowing.
Love it. Let me get in your grass. That was
the hats and the t-shirts.
We talk about branding and marketing.
Okay.
He's got that thing together. Okay.
That was good. I loved it.
Finding out about the movement behind her shop and how she celebrates women of all shapes and sizes.
She was like nimble, being nimble. Mm-hmm. And I really love that adjective, right?
Yeah.
Being able to just move. And I always say agile or being able to navigate. And then what you said was malleable, which yeah. I love that as well.
Just know she loved the words.
I do. I just try because I'm always in awe of people like you. Wildflower, Angela, they just roll off your tongue, and I'm just like, how did that happen?
I don't know.
I loved it.
You know what, though? I always loved books. I'm that kid that was in my room with a flashlight after bedtime, so I think I just have vocabulary from over the years. But this was excellent because I feel so inspired. You know, and I'm glad to send out that hope into the world because there are people that I talk to and they are weighed down by this moment. It's almost like they let it come and sit on their shoulders. And I'm just so blessed to be surrounded by people that even when it did come away, we said, get it off. Get it off. Shake it off.
Because we still got this one here to talk to about how the COVID impacted her. So, Adrian. Now you on the situation with
Adrian. Talk to us, girl, you know. So tell the people what COVID did for you. What happened to you during this time?
What happened to me during this time? So I'm in Kansas City now. But I live in Houston, Texas. So I live in Houston, Texas, and I work at Houston Community College as an academic advisor. So I'm in education, right? So I'm in education, and I'm also a mom as well, a mom of a fabulous 5-year-old. So COVID, you know, really stopped me, you know, it stopped me at home, you know, and what it really did is it allowed me to learn my daughter in ways that I didn't know her before. I mean, I live with my child. She lives with me. I see her every day.
Does she live with you?
Does she live with me? Or do I live with her? You know? But, you know, you raise your children, you see them every day, but being at home with them every single day is a whole different experience. What I'm grateful for now, you know, it was overwhelming at first, but what I am grateful of now is that it showed me her learning behaviors. It showed me just the behaviors that she has, her personality and everything. And it allowed me to allow her to be her. In this time, you know, I was trying to find myself and find out what I needed to do in COVID. But what I found out is I need to pour into her.
Ooh.
Her gifts that she has, pouring into her, allowing her to express herself at 5 years old. Because that's what she's gonna know, she's gonna remember these experiences, because we call these, you know, the kids of COVID, right?
Yeah.
Our kids of COVID. It's a whole different experience.
Yeah.
She's planning to go to the kindergarten in the fall. Yeah. So it's a whole different experience for our kids. Mm. And so during this time, it really made me to slow down, and it made me to take care of myself more as well.
Mm.
You know, like I got up in the morning and did walks, you know, it gave me an opportunity to talk with God and just like really take care of myself, because I found out if I'm going to be any good to her, I had to be good to myself.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what COVID has taught me as a single mom. Like,
yeah.
I didn't know how I was going to get through, but I did.
And
it comes with the tribe, my bomb mm-hmm. tribe, you know, and I asked for help. Any moms out there, ask for help this time, because I was one that I can do it myself. You know, we call ourselves the do too much crew, you know, I'll do it myself. I'll do it. No, I don't have to ask nobody. I can do it. I can mm-hmm. do it. And it's like, no, we're greater together.
Yes.
So COVID told
greater
me
together.
To slow down,
mm-hmm.
ask for help. Yes. We're greater together. Wow. And I was able to pour into my child and see her on a whole nother level.
And we were able to see her child
these
on a whole nother level.
Great. I mean, you know, I didn't know what angle you were going to come from, but I love that. I think that's something people hadn't even thought about, you know, how much you got to know your child in this season. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. now you know her behaviors. You know when the teacher calls you. Because it's, you know, I work with kids all the time. And
yes.
Some parents be acting like you lying on their kid.
Seriously, because there was some stuff that I wouldn't know.
Be lying on your kid. I don't.
Right.
I'm telling you, this is tough for me because I got 25 others. And this one is causing a difference. But people don't get to see there, and
they
I used to know that as an educator. I've always like worked, and I always say after school, cool. I've always done like, you know, worked with kids in cool capacities. But I would realize that they spent more time at school than they did with the parents. If you stay with me through the after school program until 6 or 7 at night, it's about 2 hours before bedtime, and then you come back to school in the morning. And so there was a, you know, and then you get to kick it on the weekends, and people just want to be cool because I haven't seen you all week.
Exactly.
But now it's like a real, I think all families have authentic relationships.
Seriously, it is so true.
It's such a change, and it's a strange change that we're all just in our homes. We have dinner together, and it seems like that should be status quo, but it's definitely not the status quo, because what's really running our lives? And that's how this thing was birthed, like the gifts, what COVID has given us.
Mm-hmm.
COVID gave us the fact that the world stood still enough for when there was brutality against another Black individual, that the people were like, this is ridiculous. Is this really going on? Does this really happen? It was different this time because there was nothing else that was distracting them from the actual truth.
Yeah.
COVID really is something. It's something. And I'm really, you know, it's heartbreaking, all the stories about people dying, you know. But what I do have to say is that plagues and things of this sort, they happen.
Yeah.
And fortunately, we haven't experienced something like this in a long time. Since 1918? The bird flu of 1918. But before there, if you really study history, this is not anything new. But thank goodness that we have the measures in place to kind of keep it, you know, kind of contained. But,
you know what? I don't know how we did it, but we got 2 minutes left.
Oh, okay? Lord.
So this is a wrap. COVID blessed us. I'm super grateful for the time here.
Yes, this was so fun. I'm so glad I was in the studio.
I'm happy too.
But we have good energy that we push out into the world, and hoping we inspire other people to look for the light. Look for the light. COVID is here. And I used to say it's a supernatural shift. It's a shifting. And, you know, and the word speaks to that, right? The first will be last and the last will be first. Like,
first.
There is a shift happening. So don't be afraid.
Be afraid of the shift.
There's a shift. And, like, I wanted to just say this. There are three types of people. People who make things happen. people who watch things happen and people who wonder how those things actually happen. Mm-hmm. In the COVID, make sure you're not on that third end. You don't want to be the second or the third. You want to make some stuff happen. Yes, because you got the time, if you have the vision, if you have the capabilities, if you know the resources, make these things happen. Corona ain't got us.
Yeah,
it ain't got us.
Make it happen.
Absolutely. Well, great, you guys. We did it once again. So you guys are more energy. But tonight was positive. We're looking at the positive attributes that COVID gave us, the gifts it gave us. I think we could do a part two of this. We didn't even get to any of the tea. But we kept it positive and uplifted. So.
And it was awesome. And I just feel such a glow right now. So, yes, hashtag the things that COVID gave us. Yes. Thank you.
So, all right, y'all. Well, before this thing just totally cuts us out, we thank you for joining us. You know, we'll have clips up soon. Follow us at Kiki and Kimonos, and we'll see you next.